This Holy Mass is brought to you in collaboration with Ricardo O. Santiago, Stu and Nancy Santiago, APM Ad and Promo Management, Alex P. Montañez and Family, Anflocor Group of Companies, Ernie and Mercy Evangelista, St. John Paul II College of Davao, Royal Bread House Incorporated, Quilan's Food House, Dimdi Center and Dimdi Builders, Tat and Gigi Coronel and Family, Teresita Villabrille, Tilinaw Trucking Services, iCrafter Optical Incorporated, Davao Durian Laundry Services Company, Chardon, Esper Laundry Services, Camphor Realty Corporation, JDB Diversified Incorporated, Consolidated Plywood Industry Incorporated, Davao Bonifacio Motors Incorporated, Melvin E. Aviles, Friends of Paulines, Renato and Porita Lorenzo, Attorney and Mrs. Ellie Britannia and Family, Ampi Casas and Family, Protasio Takandong, Anonymous, Rudy and Jean Subiaco, Ramline Resources Incorporated, Davao Great Wall Incorporated, Davao Diamond Industrial Supply, Ideal Pawn Shop Incorporated, Farmacia Quiza, Ahensa Kimsan Corporation, and Davao LB Junk Store.
Offering of the Holy Mass. Accept, Most Holy Trinity, this sacrifice fulfilled at one time by the Divine Word and now renewed on this altar through the hands of your priest. I unite myself to the intentions of Jesus Christ, priest and victim, that I may be entirely offered for your glory and for the salvation of all people. Through Jesus Christ, with Jesus Christ, and in Jesus Christ, I intend to adore your eternal majesty, to thank your immense goodness, to satisfy your offended justice, and to beseech your mercy for the church, for my dear ones, and for myself.
We pray for the intentions of our regular sponsors, choir members, donors, offerers and volunteers of this Holy Mass, especially the sponsoring group, the city government of Tagum, headed by Mayor Alan L. Relion, with the special participation of the Department of Agriculture, Region 11, under the headship of Regional Director, Engineer Remelin Recoter, and the Ateneo de Davao Grade 3 pupils. Thanksgiving intentions and blessings of Mayor Alan Relion and family, Marcelino and Edna Gilario and family, Chings Lutong Bahay, Maria Teresa Martinez Punungbayan, Engineer Adonis C. Fuerzas and family, Attorney and Nara Lubipa and family, Engineer June Coquilla and family, Agustilo and Ernal family, Tagum City Tourism and Investment Promotions Office, Engineer Riza R. Sangalang, City Architects Office, and Farah Jane Ferrando. Good health of Nicanor Relion, recovery and healing of Rudolfo, Jermin Chu, Emil Sison, Dr. Carlos Tan, and Abundia Antalan Lopez. For the eternal repose of Luciana Milagros Villa Abrilie, all benefactors and sponsors of Pauline's RTV programs, Lucia Lopez Relion, Leticia Agustilo, Jane Joselito Rinerio, and Rinante.
Pray for the sick. Lord and Father, God without end and almighty, through your grace, you give us strength and help us in our weakness. In your mercy, touch the sick people, deliver them and their sicknesses, and restore them good health, so that assured of your goodness and love, they will praise and thank you in your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, good morning. It is very significant that the gospel of salvation arrive in the Philippines with the image of Santo Niño. This is indeed a cause of abundant joy and great rejoicing. The feast bring to our attention the mystery of childhood, meaning having the open and trusting disposition to accept the Lord's gifts with gratitude, while seeing ourselves as humble stewards who serve the Lord in the list of our brothers and sisters. The presider of this Eucharistic celebration is Monsignor Bonnie Burlaza, this Filipino visiting priest from West Indies. The choir during the Mass is the Harmonic Singers of San Pedro Cathedral, Davao City. Come, let us joyfully celebrate the banquet of love, and we praise and thank Santo Niño, the infant Jesus, for the blessings you received throughout the year through a dance.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Let us give a round of applause for our Santo Niño. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, good morning. Greetings to the Tagumians, people from Tagum City. So greetings to all of you, so that during this celebration, we will pray for you and for all of us listening and seeing the television and those who are also praying with us. You know that this devotion to the Holy Child has been in our nerves, in our system, and you saw that A while ago, the children were playing, but I just make a comment. We celebrate Santo Niño, but they are all girls. So that is the irony of that celebration, only one boy. Anyway, that's part of the celebration. I hope that we will take note of that. But it is a Niño, therefore it is a boy. All right? Because that is a tradition, let us make it part of our celebration. Now let us call to mind our sins and be sorry for them. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Oh,
us pray. Almighty God, your only Son, begotten from all ages, humbled himself as a child in Nazareth and became subject to Mary and Joseph. Grant that we may learn from his example to embrace your will in all things, and holding fast to the dignity of all, serve our lowly brothers and sisters with open hands and gentle heart. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Isaiah prophesies that through the child, who shall be called Prince of Peace, God will grant peace and rejoicing to his people. The first reading.
From the book of prophet Isaiah. The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on the shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed as in the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Faithfulness toward the house of Israel.
God loves us and has made us his adopted children in Christ. Paul reminds us to live up to our dignity by leading a holy and blameless life. The second reading.
From the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ. In accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted to us in the Beloved. Therefore, I too, hearing of your faith in the Lord Jesus, of your love for all the holy ones, do not cease giving thanks for you, remembering you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of our hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call, what are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Each year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the feast of Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to the festival custom. After they had completed its days, as they were returning, the boy Jesus remained behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Thinking that he was in the caravan, they journeyed for a day and looked for him among their relatives and acquaintances, but not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were astounded at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to him, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." And he said to them, "Why are you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. And he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. And Jesus advanced in wisdom and age and favor before God and man. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord. Happy Fiesta sa tanan. Greetings nga to kang Mayor Rolion and his family and the government workers, employees, and all the people of God listening to us, watching and praying, of course, and especially for the sick. This is a special mass for them. Before I go with my reflection today, let me tell you a little story, and I want you to reflect on this. Ako lang binisayon para maklaro. Kaya naglisor kong bisaya ba? Oh, in English. Dahil usa ka bata, anak sa usa ka Kristiyano nga Katoliko. Usa ka adlaw ni ana, ang bata nakakita sa kabayo sa ilang silingan nga gikargahan og daghang butang og ang kabayo gisakyan pagayod. Mingon ang bata sa iyang amahan, Tay, sigurado gyud kayo ko nga kanang kabayo Katoliko. Ingon ang amahan, Dong, ngano nakaingon ka man ni ana nga ang kabayo Katoliko? Tay, mitubag ang bata, tungod kay ang kabayo nagmugot. I don't know how to make that English, nagmugot. Huh? Oh, correct. I wanted to say that, but I know it is that, but I don't know if everybody will understand what is pouting. Pouting sa, in English pa, mugat og naong. Diba? Okay. Now, we have been, at the beginning of the Mass, we have been dancing, and many, many centuries ago, people were doing that. But of course, as media develops and so on, especially these days with the technology that is so high, and people are already exchanging pleasantries among themselves throughout the world. I asked myself, when Sister Rica asked me to celebrate this, I said, yes. But when I look at the calendar, it is Santo Niño. I said, oh my God, it is not in the liturgy of the church. But we are granted to have the special privilege that the third Sunday, or the third Sunday in January, we will celebrate this. That is the after baptism of Christ. Historically, let's go back to history, so that may bow tatanan ba, what is happening? The Spaniards, they were fond of evangelizing and going to, from Spain, going to inland Europe. And of course, before this, the United States was converted, they went to Europe around the year 10,000. And there were waves of missionaries converting others to the Christian life. And they went further on, even to Russia. And you know, the Spaniards at that time, especially in the 13th century, that was the Baroque. You heard the Baroque? Yeah, the Baroque style of houses and form of architecture. And they were fond of making statues, sculpturing, and painting, as well as in Italy, they are fond of painting. And also, they happened to carve a small statue, besides, and they were bringing this child, Jesus now, they were bringing it to Germany, to Poland, and to Bohemia. At the time, it was called Bohemia, and it is called now Czech Republic. And so that was the whole thing. The Spaniards were searching, and of course, they passed the statue to different congregations, different missionaries. And so it was landing in Prague, in Czechoslovakia. And that was the whole thing. That's why we have the shrine here in at Matina. They got the replica of that statue. But just the same, when the Spaniards came to the Philippines through Mexico, they brought that statue. And the same kind of replica they were making, so they brought one, including the Nazareno. Originally, that was at black. But because the houses where they were housed burned, and so they were blackened. But the only thing is miracle. Why they got no fire? They got nothing. And that's why when they discovered, they call it Black Nazarene, whatever they call, and still Santo Nino. Now, way back to Prague, when the Carmelite Descalzes offering to renovate the church of Victoria or Victory, the priests, Father Cyril, found that a statue was lying on the floor with no hands. But he picked it up and put that in the sanctuary. But the statue was pestering Father Cyril. Said, "Father, have pity on me, as I will have pity on you. Please give me back my hands." And the priest said, "I don't have the instrument to put back your hands." And so, what happens? The Santo Niño that has no hands said, "Father, bring me at the entrance of the church." So the priest put the statue without hands on the table, and so the statue was there. And he said, "If you put me at the entrance of the church, wherever, as long as people can see, so you will get help." I said, and the priest said, "Oh my God, how can I have very few people coming to church? Anyway, believe me, if you have pity on me, I will have pity on you." So the priest put the statue again. No, it was in the middle of the church. And a miracle happened. When people seeing that statue without arms, one man said, "Father, I will offer, someone has to fix that. I will give you the money, everything, and someone has to come and fix it." And it was fixed. And you see, the miracle there is that when that Santo Niño was fixed, it was miraculous. Why? Because as he said, "If you help me, if you have pity on me, put back my hands, I will help you." And they were able to put up a big church, and afterwards it became Cathedral of Prague. And even our late Cardinal Sin was there. And this is the same replica in Spain that they brought here to the Philippines. And that's why the miracle there is that this is, I would contribute it. That I have been around so many places in many other countries. I have not seen in my life the outpouring of our faith to God. And through the Nazareno and through the Holy Infant Jesus. You see? Why? Because if we believe like a child, then we are trusting God in all our endeavors. Have you asked yourself every year why we celebrate this phenomenon of the Fiesta of the Santo Niño? What is the relevance? The relevance that I see to help us would be this. Let us first of all be grateful to God of our faith. Let us be grateful. Let us be thankful, all of us, whether we are young or old, whatever, is that, are we thankful to God for this faith? And also, in our gospel today, Mary was and Joseph, they were going to the temple. I would encourage that parents also bring your children to church. Some people say, oh, the children are noisy. No, no. As long as you are tolerant and as long as you teach your children to behave in the church. Okay? Just take that. Because sometimes, you know, especially the mothers, mostly that we say, why this is a phenomenon, why very many women are in the church rather than men? Because, this is my observation, as a social scientist, I observe this. Kanang mga ginikanan, labi na ang inahan, mayroon sila, sige, manimba na ta. Ang mga anak lalaki, mutakilid, mayroon, onya na. Diba? It's a phenomenon. Onya na. Ang inahan, ang dalit niya mabira, ang mga babae. O sige, tara, manimba ta. So muna nga, daghang mga babae na nimba kaysa lalaki. Diba? Mm. Now, kamong ginikanan, so I put it in Cebuano, parang klaro ba? Kaya ron ang ginikanan diha inyong dasigon. Di lang kaya ang babae, lalaki tanan, kaya ang lalaki ay kalag. Ba? You need to assess parents, assess your children. And you have to remember some parents also. You have to remember that parents are stewards, custodians of your children. You are not the owner of your children. God is the owner. God is just using you to propagate life. But you are stewards. Amen? Amen. Yes, brothers and sisters. And also, teach your children to be in the community. Look at the JK case now, our BECs. Kanang mo tambong, I noticed that only old people, katunang mga, di na kayo kadungog, katunang mga ngulbo-ngulbo na, no? O, muna ilang pasimbahon, katunang nagkurog-kurog na, o, kay paingon na sa langit daw, so kailangan mo simba. Oh boy. No. Tanan, pasimbahon, dito sa chapel. You have to participate. No? Okay, I encourage those who are in the BECs and the JKKs. Bilang kayo mga leaders. Atong encourage sila. Nga naman, because Mary, Joseph, and Jesus came with the caravan. That's very strong. And then, you have to teach your children to look for God in prayer. To look for God in prayer. You have to make them search. Meaning to say, you have to teach them the basic prayer. Istorya ni Juan Posong ba? Kailan mo ni Juan Posong? Ituluan siyang nanay. Hail Mary, glory be, hasta pagpangoros. Anyap. Gikapuyan si Juan Posong, kay Juan Posong lagi. Iyang gisuwat sa Manila paper, ang tanan niyang prayers. Paghuman, iyang gidikit sa bongbong. Iyang mga rosya, ni kabuntag, magabi eh. Iyang alas man, sa anak, Espiritu Santo, amen. Lord, ikaw na lang basa. Mora posong, iba? One posong. So, parents should be grateful. When you have children, kanakang ginikanan, mayon, Father, pastilan in town, dekang menganak, bukat kayo. Inom-inom mo sa kabayo. Inom-inom mo sa kabayo. O, muna. Ang kabayo nagmugot kay kargado hasta tag-iyan ni sakay. Inana na mga Katoliko, gamugot. Mato ka dito sa mga tindahan, mayang buntag. Buntag, maestos. Kung Katoliko ka, ngisi. You see, because you have to show that God is in you, you are happy. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, hindi pagkuan sa kamo sa gobyerno ba? Oh, sa mga tala mo, ngisin mo bisikapoy na, huh? Because you are showing God to these people who are coming to you. You are the bearer of Christ. Pagkuan sa manang Santo Niño, na uban atog palingki one time. Was still on in town. Purigaba lang. Uto po, gaba po. Ikaw, Brad, bisara daw ng isda, be. Bisara na. Diba mo? Nilingi. Panaw sa tunin niyo. Nga, yang gi, ana itong iyang timbangan. Nga, diskumpiado ko, ato ko sa amigo na ako, ikaw, timbangan na ni. Uy, kulang magduha kaguhit. Ikaw, Maud ito nga nilingi sa tuwi na lang head kadua ka guhit. Okay. Sininaan, tayo ba karog sinina? Police, Metro Aid, kuya no, Metro Aid, napay fisherman, tanang-tanang klase. Bisan pag usaw ni muna, if you are fooling others, you don't receive graces. You don't receive graces because ayaw pananggit nga magbinoang kasaya. Okay? So, all these things we should have. Kung natay devotion sa ito ninyo, we have to grow in our Christian life. Let's go to have a devotion. Ako na ko devotion sa ito ninyo sa Nazareno. Pero kinangla mo, tubo uta. That's why at the end of the gospel today, it says, Jesus grow with them in Nazareth. Before God and man in wisdom and age. So we have to grow for that. So brothers and sisters, the relevance of that, let us continue our devotion. Don't keep that faith in you. It's nice. Many people will say, oh, look at atong Nazareno bitaw last week. Yeah? Karagang tao, murag fanatic, di ba? But many people will heal. We have to show our faith. We have to show our devotion. We have to show everything so that the glory of God, Saint Irenaeus said, the glory of God is man fully alive. John 10:10, Jesus says, I come to bring you the fullness of life. And that is Christianity, to be full in the life of God. And that's why last week we have that baptism, that we have the fullness of God in life so that we who are walking here now will have that fullness of life, bringing to one another the gratefulness of God, because God, remember this, is always faithful to us. Kita may nagbinuang ba? Diba? We commit sin. That's why we make foolishness. But let us ask God to help us, the Holy Infant, and all this will help us grow in age and wisdom, so that we become holy every day with God. Amen.
Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and by Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered and was buried, and rose again
from the dead,
and ascended
into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living
and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, On this feast of the Senior Santo Niño, let us pray to the Father to make us worthy of being his beloved children. Let us remember in a special way the children of this nation and of the world. And we shall pray, hear the prayers of your children, Lord.
For the children of the Filipino nation and all children the world over, may they live in security and warmth, growing up as lovers of peace and committed citizens of their countries. We shall pray.
Hear the prayers of your children, Lord.
For adults, may they care for all children, show them the beauty of life, and bring them up responsibly. May they never lose the spirit of a child and so live with one another in friendship, freedom, and openness. We pray.
Hear the prayers of your children, Lord.
For the Filipino electorate, may they exercise their right to vote for our leaders, shun vote buying, give priority to the good of the country over vested interest, and see to it that the campaigns and elections be done in a peaceful and credible manner. We pray.
Bear the prayers of your children, Lord.
For our people, may our celebration of the Feast of the Santo Niño be marked not only by cultural and religious festivities, but also by a deepening of faith in Christ, who is always attuned to the will of the Father. We pray.
Hear the prayers of your children.
For the celebration of the International Eucharistic Congress, may the celebration and every Eucharist we participate in strengthen our resolve to always trust in the providence of the Father, like a child trusting to his father. We pray.
Hear the prayers of your children, Father.
That the healing grace of God may purify those who have died, especially the sponsors, benefactors, and cooperators of the TV Mass production. We pray.
Hear the prayers of your children. Father, hear the prayers of your children who trust in you. May your word and the Eucharist be our support and our guide. Give us a childlike disposition, for your kingdom belongs to the children. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
God, our Creator, we offer the gifts of bread and wine to recall the childhood of your only Son. Let our offering become the sacrifice of him who brought forgiveness and peace to the world. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the
Let
Lord.
Us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For on the feast of this awe-filled mystery, though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours and begotten before all ages. He has begun to exist in time so that, raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation and call string humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Romuald, our Bishop, all the order of bishops, clergy, religious, and all our intentions today, and especially for those who are sick. May God heal you when you believe in the infant Jesus and in the Nazareth, all those who are in need of his help. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, with Saint Peter and Saint Paul who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, yes, Lord, deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
A big smile let us offer each other. Feast of the Santo Niño. Give me sign of peace. The Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. Let us pray. Loving Father, you have nourished us at a banquet in honor of the child born of the Virgin. We pray that we may advance in wisdom and grow daily in faith and works of love, so that we may find favor in your sight. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now we pray for the prayer for the International Congress of the Eucharist. Lord Jesus Christ, our hope of glory, you are the fulfillment of the Father's plan to save all humanity. You are the mystery hidden from the ages and from generations past, now manifest to us. You abide in your most holy sacrament of the Eucharist. As we celebrate the Holy Eucharist and receive your body and blood, grant us the awareness that your presence urges us to continue your saving mission in the world. Send us your Holy Spirit, that he may lead us to walk humbly with the poor and the marginalized in the company of Mary, your most holy mother and ours. O Lord, in the most blessed sacrament, To you be all honor and glory and praise in the unity of the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Before the Mass is ended, and let us follow the footsteps of Jesus.
Thanks be to God.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Pagkakataon sa Santo Niño. Praise the Lord.